A massive cyber attack left Twitter, Netflix, PayPal, Reddit, Spotify, and other popular websites at a standstill today. 24-hour News 8's Marley Ginter is at the live desk with more on this. Marley?
Well, Emily, this all happened because of what's called a DDoS, or denial of service attack, on the large-scale domain manager Dyn. So a post on Hacker News first identified the cyber attack mainly affecting the U.S. East Coast. And while it was not immediately clear who was behind this attack or why, affected companies took to Twitter to post updates to customers once that social network was back online. So here to explain exactly what happened today and really what a DDoS attack is, I'm going to bring in John High, the COO of Trivalent Group, also a cybersecurity expert for the Michigan Small Business Development Center. Thank you so much, Mr. High, for being with us. So really, what can we explain to people at home? What is a DDoS attack?
So a DDoS attack is a distributed denial of service attack, and it's basically a flood of traffic on the internet or a network. And that flood of traffic squells out any legitimate traffic that's trying to occur.
We had so many websites affected by this today. How could this be so widespread?
Yeah, so it's unfortunately easy for someone with bad intentions to create an attack like this. They can literally rent the capabilities to do this. And they attack a central service, which is what Dyn is, where the Amazons and the Twitters all use their service. It's akin to the power grid being taken out for us here in the city.
What should people at home then be thinking about? Because when you hear hack and you hear that anything's been frozen, you think they could have my personal information.
Right. So this kind of attack isn't so much a compromise of personal information, although, as people have been starting to hear about the Internet of Things, we have smart devices in our homes, smart thermostats, smart refrigerators, whatever else. These devices are early in their development. They are not inherently as secure as computer systems are. And so I would, you know, from a standpoint of a home person, look at what you can do to secure your devices at home, because they have found today that some of these Internet of Things devices have participated in the attacks today.
All right, John High, a cybersecurity expert. Thank you so much for those tips today. And Emily and Sue, I'll go ahead and send it back to you. These are things that we all need to think about because this really was so widespread.